The greatest feeling you can get in a gym, or the most satisfying feeling you can get in the gym, is the pump. Let's say you train your biceps. Blood is rushing into your muscles, and that's what we call the pump. Your muscles get a really tight feeling, like your skin is going to explode any minute. You know, it's really tight. It's like somebody blowing air into your muscle. It just blows up, and it feels different. It feels fantastic.
What's up, everyone? David here. Got a new video for y'all today. But before we get into it, if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification so you don't miss out on any new videos. Remember, new videos on this channel every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. So don't miss out. Now, I'm pretty sure as you can see by the shirt, I got my boy Arnold with me right here. Signature pose, flexing it. This muscle right here, right there. That ball, I'm talking about this one. That right there is what you call a bicep. That's gonna be the focus of this video. Three tips to grow bigger biceps. I mean, think about it. That is the one thing that we all want. I mean, I don't know a single person who doesn't want big biceps. And if you are that person that doesn't want big biceps, you're wrong. We all want them. Okay, so here's what we got going on. First tip when it comes to building up your biceps. You got to stop going so fucking heavy, all right? You got to start actually getting your form down correctly. I've been seeing too many times where people are loading up too much weight on the bar and they're just swinging it like this. Bro, like at this point, is it really a bicep exercise or is it an aggressive thrusting forward motion? Same thing with dumbbells. They're going too heavy on each arm. They're swinging their arms up like this to get the weights up. I mean, come on now. Lower the weight. You do not need to go so heavy if you're going to be doing some type of curl variation. All right, at that point, the form, you're just ego lifting. I mean, let's just be honest, you're ego lifting. Are you really getting a good contraction on the bicep? Are your biceps really doing all the work to get the weight up, or are your hips doing all the work to thrust the weight forward? And I mean, let's be honest also, sometimes your elbow comes all the way up. At that point, you're also bringing your shoulder, the front part of your shoulder, bringing that arm up. Come on now. Lighten up the weight. You do not need to go so heavy. Focus on the form. Go nice and light. Really contract all the way up, all the way down. Actually feel the burn in the biceps, and you'll be surprised by how much more results you'll be getting and how much faster you'll be getting them compared to just doing this with excessively heavy weight. So that's the first tip. Second tip that we're going to be going into is going to be a specific exercise or a specific idea. But I want to ask you all this. What is the one exercise you do to really build up your chest? What is the one exercise you do to really build up the width of your back? What is the one exercise you do to really build up those thighs, get massive legs? After you answer those, hear me out. I'm pretty sure when I asked what's the exercise you do to build up your chest, I'm pretty sure you said some type of pressing motion, whether it be a barbell bench press, dumbbell bench press, incline bench press. Regardless, you did some type of pressing movement. When it came to what exercise you do to build up the width of your back, I'm pretty sure you either said some type of bent over row, dumbbell row, lat pull down, pull ups. Regardless, you either did some type of row or some type of pull down. Now, to build up the legs, I'm pretty sure you said some type of variation of squat, maybe some type of variation of a deadlift, RDL, whatever it is. What do all of these exercises have in common? They're all compound exercises. All right, what does that mean? It means that multiple joints are working in unison. Multiple joints are going through range of motion. When we're benching, what are the two joints that we're mainly using? Shoulder joint, elbow joint. Shoulder is flexing. That means bringing the arm up. Elbow is extending. That means locking it out. When we do rows, it's the opposite. Shoulder is extending. That means bringing the arm back. And elbow is flexing, which means bending it. When we do squats, what are the two, or actually three joints? It's ankles, knees, and hips. Obviously, our hips are going to be thrusting forward as we come up, and our knees are going to be locked out as we come up. All of those exercises require multiple joints to be used at the same time. Therefore, it also means that multiple muscle groups are being used at the same time. Now, when we do our biceps, what is the common exercise that we always do? We always do some type of curl, right? But here's the thing. When we really want to build up mass, we really want to build up that size, why is it that with other muscle groups, we go straight to the big compound lifts, the big multi-joint exercises, but when it comes to biceps and wanting to grow them big, we don't approach it the same way? we approach it in the sense that we're only going to do isolation exercise. Isolation exercise meaning only one joint is being used at a time. In this case, it's the elbow. Because again, what do the biceps allow us to do? They allow us to bend our elbow. We need to start taking the approach as we do with our chest, our back, our legs. If we want bigger biceps, we need to also emphasize the multi-joint movements, the compound exercise, not just the isolation exercise. So what are we going to be doing? Chin-ups, okay? We're going here. Our elbow is fully locked out. So we're getting that stretch in the bicep, and then we're coming up, and then boom, look it. We're bending our elbow all the way. A lot of people think that these type of pull-ups, chin-ups, whatever it is, if you're pulling yourself up, everyone always thinks it's just a back exercise. No, it's also a bicep exercise. I mean, think of it this way. Next time you watch the Olympics, look at the Olympians, the gymnastics specifically. Look at them. The gymnasts, their biceps are huge. They're well-developed. You think they're sitting around doing curls? No, it's just from all of this motion that they're doing on the pull-up bar or on the rings. All of that is going to contribute greatly to bigger biceps. So we need to do that same thing here in the gym. We want big biceps. Stop only doing curls. Start doing the multi-joint exercise. It's like, think of it like this. When we're doing, or when we want to build up our chest, do we really want a massive chest? Do we just do endless flies to get a massive chest? Or do we do a bunch of bench pressing? I mean, same thing with the biceps. We're not going to get as big a biceps just by only doing curls. Yes, they will grow, but take the same approach. Multi-joint exercise. Get those pull-ups in. And if you can't do a pull-up or a chin-up, cable machines, everyone, I'm talking about cables, utilizing your resources. Do a pull down, okay? There was a time when I couldn't do pull-ups or chin-ups or any variation of that. So what would I have done back in the day if I had access to it? I would have used the cable machine and started doing that. Now, specifically for biceps, I recommend you stick solely to chin-ups. That means palm facing you. The reason why is because this way the biceps will work a little bit harder. I mean, you do a regular pull-up, compare that to the feeling of a chin-up, you're gonna feel your biceps burn a lot more with a regular chin-up. So that's what you need to start doing. Lastly, third tip to grow up your biceps, you gotta start training it with a lengthened position. Now, I know many people don't really know what this means. I know you've maybe heard it. You heard it about, you're training in the shortened position. Oh, you're training in the lengthened position. What does that mean? Let's go a little bit to anatomy, take you back to your high school days. Every muscle that we have starts and ends somewhere, okay? And where it ends determines what that muscle is gonna allow us to do. So we're just gonna be focusing on the bicep only for this. Our bicep ties into, our bicep is right here on our upper arm, right? But where does it actually attach? Which bone is it attaching to? It doesn't attach to right here, this bone, which is called your humerus, even though most people might think that because the bicep is on the humerus. No, our bicep actually ties in to right here, the bones right here. Why? It's because think of it this way. The bicep starts here and it attaches here and it grips onto this. So every time we flex it, it's pulling it with it. You get what I'm saying? That's what it's doing. But most people think this is the only place that is appropriate for the bicep to be worked. No. Where else does the bicep attach? A lot of people think that this is the only thing the bicep is responsible for. No. Our bicep also attaches up here. So it actually does slightly aid in helping us do this motion. See what I'm saying? So the bicep crosses two joints. So therefore, we need to lengthen it far enough so that way it gets stretched across both joints. If we're only doing regular curls like this, we're stretching it along this bottom part right here because our elbow is locked out. But remember, it's crossing up here too. So we need to stretch out this part. And the only way we're going to go about that is if we do some type of exercise where our arm is actually behind us. This way, we're getting the full stretch. I mean, even if you were to just stand here, lock out that elbow, bring your arm back, or even have a partner bring your arm back, you'll start feeling a stretch all along your bicep right here. So what type of exercise can we do with that? Realistically, there's going to be two of them. You're either going to set a bench on an incline, lie down on it, and then boom, your arms are gonna be dangling down. You see, now I'm stretching and my arms are behind my torso and then start curling. Or you can hook up to a cable machine, have both cables on each hand, and then from right here, take a step forward so that way your arms are extended behind you and then curling it up. Both of those are really gonna allow you to train the bicep through the entire range of motion that it was meant to go through. Again, regular curls or even preacher curls. I see preacher curls are a very common one that everyone does, whether it be with a machine or a free bar. Again, it's a good exercise. It is gonna be working the biceps, but you're not, You're not stretching it all the way, okay? You're not lengthening it all the way. This is the shortened position because it's still shortened on one end. It's not fully lengthened. But if your arm is behind you, in the case of this incline bench curl and cable curls, that is what's gonna really give you that stretch and a lot better development of the bicep. Again, those are just three tips of what have personally helped me build up my biceps. But at the end of the day, as long as you're still doing some type of movement that allows you to forcefully bend your elbow, like you have to actually force it to bend against resistance, it's still gonna work out the bicep because that's what the muscle is meant to do. It's meant to help you bend the elbow. So even doing rows, dumbbell rows, cable rows, lat pull downs, all of that type of stuff, that's all bicep work as well. I mean, come on, it's not just back, you're bending your elbow. So as long as you're pushing yourself with those, giving enough resistance, getting close to failure within good quality sets, all those things have to be taken into account. And obviously being in a caloric surplus, you know, you got to eat more calories to help you put on some weight. All of that needs to be taken into account as well when it comes to building your bicep. But at the end of the day, everyone's going to be a little different. Everyone has a different select exercises that their body responds well to. It's just a matter of you taking the time to figure out what works best for you and actually sticking with it. Once you find out what are your go-to exercises, stick with it, push hard, see results. Easy. Hopefully you all enjoyed this video. Comment down below what are some tips that have helped you build your biceps. Also comment down below any other video suggestions you'd like to see me do, whether it be about mindset, motivation, nutrition, diet, workouts, programs, whatever it is, comment down below. I'll be more than happy to help you all out. Also, be sure to subscribe not just to my channel, but my girlfriend's channel, our couple's channel, so you don't miss out on any new videos. Because remember, we got new videos every week across the board for all three channels. And then for Instagram and TikTok, same thing. Be sure to follow me on my accounts, girlfriend's accounts, couple's accounts. I put all the links down in the description below. With that being said, I'll catch y'all next time.